Joe Dan, are you gonna need the fuzz pedal?
No, I just need the two screens.
Alright, got you covered.
The ukulele, too.
The ukulele. Okay, I'm gonna unplug, Jim.
Alright.
Let me get you hooked up there, brother.
This is, is this mic working?
That one should be, yes.
Yeah.
Let's get you, get it over here for you. How's it?
Testing, Jim, is this working?
Yeah.
Okay, so, and this one's working for the...
Oh, yeah.
Got a eight-string ukulele, you know, ukuleles are famous for being four-string instruments.
I knew you would surprise us tonight.
This one is, an instrument that's really, it's a baritone ukulele in terms of its size. And it's a double string, in other words, you play it like it's four, kinda like you would play a 12-string guitar, you know, finger it just like you would a six-string. They're in courses or pairs. And made by the Mele Company in Hawaii. And I have come to really like this instrument. I'm going to do a couple of songs that that are kind of old, and you may or may not have heard them, but you've, this first one is been endorsed by the National Babysitters Association as its official song, and this song was written by Wally Fowler, a guy who used to be a kind of a big shot on the Grand Ole Opry. He worked with Eddie Arnold, who at that time was just beginning in the Grand Ole Opry in the early to mid 40s, around 1943, I think this song was written. And Wally Fowler was the guy that came up with the idea for the song, and I think wrote most of the words. But Eddie Arnold and somebody else whose name escapes me right now put it together and made it a song that became quite famous in the 40s, and actually during World War II. But when Eddie Arnold, and of course Eddie Arnold was then well known as the Tennessee Plowboy, and he sang songs like this a lot in his early years. But in the 60s, when he started becoming appealing to the pop and the cosmopolitan sound, the Nashville sound and all that, he abandoned all those kind of songs and probably would not admit to having done them if they were not, you know, on record. This one is, you can find it on, probably on YouTube, but you can find it on old RCA Victor recording. And I know my folks really, when they loved to listen to the song, and it just turned my aunt who raised me, you know, she just would go, she was moved to tears every time she would hear this song. And remember, this was actually, you know, one of Eddie Arnold's biggest hits in the early days. The title of it is Please Mommy Please Stay Home With Me. kissed his cheek and tried to soothe him, but would not heed his child's plea. She heard him call as she was leaving, "Please, mommy, please, stay home with me." In trifling joy, the merry tunes and flitting chatter made her forget her baby boy. She laughed and danced and did some drinking, soon was lost sleep. Now and then these words would haunt her, "Please, mommy, please, stay home with me." The mother's life then was for her, just to hear her baby's voice again. She grieved that she had rudely left him to satisfy her wishes vain. Now mothers don't neglect their duty. This story should a lesson be. Don't ignore your baby's pleading. "Please, mommy, please, stay home with me. Please, mommy, please, stay home with me."
Maybe I did.
That's the best I remember it, though. Let me think a minute. Was there another verse to that song?
Well, what happened to the kid?
I think it's kind of left to your imagination.
Okay, all right.
I don't think there's a verse that tells you that a monster got him. Or
yeah, I thought she went home and found, you know, bad news.
I know, there's just a verse kind of hit. Remember, this was 1943.
You know? Yeah. It would have been censored.
The other song, my other song is going to be one that, similar to one, in fact, it's the same genre of one of Jack Ainsworth's songs.
Oh,
whoa. So you're all familiar with Kitties Must Die?
Oh, yeah.
Now, this is in that same genre. And,
I'm sorry, Joe Dan.
it doesn't really have a more happy ending than Kitties Must Die. Other than in a theological sense. And if you wonder what I mean by that, just remember that recently the Pope was quoted, I don't know if it was accurate or not, but he was quoted as saying that dogs do go to heaven. Was fast doctor looked at me and he said, I just can't do no more for him. With a hand that was trembling, I picked up my gun. I aimed it at Shep's faithful head. I just couldn't do it, and I wanted to run. I wish that they would shoot me instead. I walked around and sat down on the ground. He laid his head on my knee. I stroked the best pal that a man ever had. I cried, I scarcely could see. Out and he licked at my hand. He looked up at me just as much as to say, we're parting, but you understand. Well, old Shep is gone where the good doggies go, and no more with old Shep will I roam. But if dogs have a heaven, there's one thing I know, old Shep has a wonderful home. Well, I say it's in the same genre as Kitty's Must Die.
Yeah, if you want to play another one, do it.
Let's see. Well, I guess I can do an old song from the 20s or 30s. Let's see. Okay, this one is called Paper Moon.
Paper Moon.
Some of you may have heard it in the movie, there was a movie in which that might have been the title of the movie. It was a theme song with Ryan O'Neal and his daughter too. But the song goes back to the 20s and ukulele, I first made it famous, I think. Say it's only a paper moon, sailing over a cardboard sea, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Yes, say it's a paper moon hanging over a muslin dream, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Without your love, it's a honky-tonk parade. Without your love, it's a melody played in a penny arcade. It's a Barnum and Bailey work, as phony as it can be. But it wouldn't be make-believe if you believed in me. Yes, say it's only a paper moon, sailing over a cardboard sea, but it wouldn't be make-believe if you believe in me, if you believe in me.
Yeah. Jill, do you want to play another one?
Jerry,
baby. Jerry. Guys, where'd you go, guys?
Okay.
He said he loaned it to your lover earlier.
There you go. Welcome.